is, I kind of thought the whole point was that we all matter. Am I missing something? You know, I get the tension thing. I get the reaction to violence and the reaction to injustice. I really do understand it. But you know, we still live in what I consider to be the greatest country in the world. Show of hands, America, greatest country in the world. This place is unbelievable. We got so much bounty. We got so much. Our leftovers can feed like 20 countries. That's how awesome America is. We are so unbelievably fortunate. We're so fortunate that almost everybody on the planet wants to move here. So there's going to be problems. There's going to be tension. And I don't know. I guess I'm just stupid. Call me dumb. But I just don't get the whole, you know, we're the only ones that matter. Look out for us. Because if you don't, we're going to shoot you. I think that's fucking retarded. It's a very, very dangerous position to take. And I feel sad for those people who lose their lives senselessly. They can't raise their children. They can't be a brother. They can no longer be a co-worker, a teammate, an uncle, a dad, a husband, a wife, a sister, your cousin. They're all gone. This song's like 50 years old. Anybody realize that? Right? 66, right? Yeah, 66. 50-year-old song. Guy from Boston in the back. Talked to you earlier. Right? 50-year-old song makes absolutely perfect sense. Beyond that, written by a teenager. Buffalo Springfield couldn't even vote. They couldn't even drink alcohol legally and pen this lyric. People, pay attention to me. Come down here. My brothers and sisters, I love you all so much. This is really emotional to me. I'm serious. I'm not messing around. This is some hardcore shit. We live in a crazy, crazy time that 50 years ago, we were talking about the same problem. The same thing. And now we got 787 channels of the news on. 24/7, 365, regurgitating a bunch of crap to make us afraid. Try to make us afraid. But I'm not gonna be afraid. I'm not gonna take it. I'm not gonna sit down and listen to some gospel preaching shit fuck tell me what I can and can't do because I live in America. Man. I get to put in a rock and roll band. I get to drop the F-bomb on the stage. That's what I do. I play in a fucking rock and roll band. My kids love it. My wife loves it. They're proud of me. And I'm happy to say I play with some of the best people in the world, people. These are my brothers of love and rock and roll. We take this stage with meaning. It's not a joke. I'm honored to play this song. I'm honored to play the music we play. I'm honored to play with people. And you come and enjoy it. You dance with me. And you sweat. And you love. And you hug. And you pat me on the back at the end of the night when I can't even walk and say thank you. I'm feeling love. their friggin' station wagon. So this is my rendition of this song getting written, by the way. I don't know this to be true. I do know that they were trying to get a record deal. And as the story goes, they kind of like scribbled this lyric on a napkin or something. It's like, hey man, this is kind of cool. Come on, guys. Sing this one with me. Paranoia strikes deep into my head, it will creep.